IVM.
Hello and welcome to the Habit Coach podcast. I am Ashdin Doctor, your habit coach. Today's fun fact of the day is that in a survey conducted in 2017, the top 5 New Year resolutions were: number 1, diet; number 2, exercise more; number 3, lose weight. And these are all body composition goals. Number 4 was save more and spend less. And number 5, learn a new skill. Save more and spend less was just 32%, while all the other goals, like diet, exercise, lose weight, were at 75%. Our world is clearly obsessed with losing weight. Finance and self-development goals are a distant fourth. As we learned from our last podcast, 80% of these resolutions will never see the second month end. They will once again be created as resolutions for the next year. Every year we try to do the same thing, wishing for a different result. Einstein supposedly said the definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over again and expecting different results. So let's stop driving ourselves insane this year and try something radical. Let's try actually achieving our New Year resolutions. In any business or company, we keep yearly, quarterly, and monthly targets. So then why don't we do the same for our own personal lives? Why do we wake up at the end of the year to reassess our goals and our resolutions? It's time to start treating our personal goals with the same formality and intensity as our work. The importance of having a monthly and quarterly check is to make sure we are on the right path early on so we can change the trajectory as needed. Chances are your habits will survive the first month. The second month onwards, things start getting tricky. So make monthly plans instead of yearly plans. On the last day of each month, sit down and think about your goal and habit. Ask yourself, are you on plan? What are the difficulties faced? Is there a way to deal with these difficulties? Are you overperforming? Is the habit too easy? Should we make the goal harder? Should we change the time of day for the habit? Is it time to upgrade? Doing this every month will give you a great sense of clarity and achievement. At the end of the quarter or 3 months, chances are you would have surpassed your expectations. Take a long, hard look at the goal you had set. Do you want to change it? Refocus your energy elsewhere. Be critical and rate your performance. Remember, you are the boss of you. So your habits for the New Year resolutions are: 1. Set shorter duration plans. Instead of yearly goals, set monthly or quarterly plans. And number 2, create a review system at the end of each month and at the end of each quarter. In the next podcast, we discuss the most important tool for achieving your New Year resolution. So start these habits and share with us your progress using the hashtag TheHabitCoach. If you like this podcast, don't forget to check out other interesting podcasts on the IVM network. You can listen to us on the IVM Podcast app or ivmpodcast.com. You can also follow us on social media. We are at IVM Podcasts on Twitter and Instagram. If you want to reach out to me, I am Ashdin Doc on Twitter and Instagram.
Have you gotten yourself a gym membership and shown up only a few times? Are long working hours cutting your fitness goals short? How about you change things a little? Even a small effort can make a big difference. And I'll tell you how and what exactly. Hi guys, I'm Coach Urmi, and on the Kinetic Living podcast, you can look forward to some interesting stories of people who have changed the way they look at fitness after their kinetic journeys. Episodes out every Wednesday on the IVM app, website, and anywhere you get your podcast from.
Family businesses get a bad rap, and one time they were looked down on for getting rich, for being too ambitious. Today they're still looked down on, but for not being ambitious enough. Not agile enough, not modern enough, too traditional in their mindset. The biggest brands and business houses in the country started out as humble family businesses. It's the way India has done business. Join Sonu Bhasin in conversation with stalwarts of Indian family businesses on the Inheritors podcast series by Bloomberg Quint. Discuss the highs and lows, the needs and pressure points of building a business legacy that spans generations.